state-of-the-art treatments from one of the country's top burn units. It's an emotional story in the true spirit of neighbors helping neighbors. Monday on NBC Action News at 10.
Let's talk about a topic close to home, your home. Sunday mornings, you'll be at home with James B. Nutter. Home buying, home financing, Sundays at 10:30.
This shoe is half off, and so are over 8,000 other pair during our women's half-off back rack sale, now in progress at Bob Jones Shoes, 19th and Grand, downtown.
We get everybody fits.
Can the Royals bounce back from a dismal season? We're live from Arizona. Plus, the battle for the Big 12 as KU shoots it out with OSU Sunday at 10:25.
You are watching NBC. Through the next decade, America's Olympic Network. This is the NBC Sports Update. Here's Dan Hicks.
Hi, everyone. Welcome to our New York studio. Coming up in just a few minutes, it's the National Lacrosse League's All-Star Game live from Calgary. That's followed up by gymnastics. It's the American Cup presented by TJ Maxx, where you'll see athletes like 2003 world champion Chelsea Memel compete. First, though, a quick look at the AFL last night, where several teams were in action. The 3-1 Orlando Predators headed to Chicago to take on the Rush. Chicago Rush owner Mike Ditka doing a little in-game jawing there, and he's probably going to jaw on this guy after the game because Jeremy McDaniel gets stripped of the ball at the one. Orlando recovers, and on the ensuing Predator drive, quarterback Joe Hamilton finding Jimmy Frizzle from 13 yards out to put Orlando up 24-21. They would go on to win it by a final of 48-35 as the Predators up their record to 4-1. Elsewhere, New Orleans, before a crowd of more than 16,000, the second largest all time to watch the Voodoo in the New Orleans arena, beat Tampa Bay in overtime, 48-42. And Nelson Garner's 49-yard field goal as time expired lifted the Georgia Force to a wild 66-63 victory and continued their best franchise start in history. And don't forget, tomorrow the AFL and NBC returns with a quarterback shootout fit for the Wild West as the Cowboy Kid Clint Sterner in Dallas ride into Philly to take on Lightning lefty Tony Graziani and Bon Jovi's gang. Others will see Colorado take on Los Angeles for regional action. That's the AFL on NBC at 3 o'clock Eastern Time, 12 noon Pacific. That'll do it for now. We'll see you a little bit later on today. Right now, enjoy the lacrosse.
From the home of the defending champion, Calgary Roughnecks, you can forget the concept of all-star games without intensity. Not a quiet day in this forecast. It's the fastest, toughest contest on 2 feet. Jordan of lacrosse, hoping his final bow comes with a mammoth all-star appearance. He's a seven-time league scoring champ, an unstoppable bandit, just the second player to score 1,000 points. He's a wide-eyed rookie from Princeton. This stealth star might just be the future of American lacrosse. He's got quick hands, fast feet, big numbers. This Nighthawk has the league's sharpest shot. All of them on one piece of carpet in Calgary. From Canada, the birthplace of lacrosse, NBC proudly presents the 2005 National Lacrosse League All-Star Game, brought to you by Vonage. And this afternoon from Pengrove Saddle Dome, it's the best from the five teams in the Eastern Division against the best from the five in the West. The Players inside the cage masks have talked about the significance of putting on a good show, that this is a sport on the cusp of something great, since so many fans in the United States are going to see this for the very first time. Good afternoon, everyone. Along with Brian Shanahan, I'm Mike Emmerich. This is Professor Shanahan here, who's got the basic course in lacrosse.
Yeah, well, lacrosse is a sport rich in history and tradition. It's been around for hundreds of years, but the National Lacrosse League has been around for almost 20 years, and you're going to see a lot of similarities to hockey. There's a lot of hard-hitting end-to-end action, the odd fight. It's also a lot like basketball with a lot of picks, a 30-second shot clock over back line. But it's a lot like the NFL, too. There's only 16 games in the season. Every game's like a playoff game, and there's a lot of intensity.
Some of the best offensive players this afternoon, including the leading scorer in the circuit right now, a guy from the Rochester Nighthawks known as John Grant.
Yeah, John Grant was drafted out of the University of Delaware in 1999. The first pick that year. It was the Rookie of the Year. He's got great numbers. He was overshadowed a little bit by Gary Gate, Tavares. We'll talk about them later. But this year, he's number one. 66 points in just 9 games. He has got the best stick in the league. He's like a magician.
The starters were selected in a combination vote, one-third by the fans, one-third by the media, one-third by the general managers of the teams.
Yeah, these guys are all great players, but watch for John Tavares. He's got 1,000 points in his career.
Turning to the West, Tracy Kolusky is an example of one of those players who has come from the outdoor lacrosse leagues, college lacrosse, in the United States, and he's one of the foremost players on this Western squad.
Yeah, from University of Hartford, he is the captain of the Calgary team, the defending champs, and he's a leader in every sense of the word. He's got good numbers, not as great as Johnny Grant, but this guy scores the big goal when it's needed. He doesn't know how to quit, and believe it or not, these guys were childhood friends growing up. They're best friends, but on the floor, they'll look like enemies. They're great competitors.
The starters for the West include the all-time leader in goals and assists and points, Gary Gate of Colorado.
Well, Gary Gate is like the Wayne Gretzky, the Michael Jordan of lacrosse. He's done more to sell this game everywhere than anybody. We'll be talking about him a lot tonight.
And that legend is downstairs right now with our legend, Mark Morgan.
Mike, thank you very much. Gary Gate is considered the ambassador for this game. And Gary, what can we expect to see in this All-Star game that will be like unlike any other All-Star game we've seen before in other sports?
Oh, you're going to see passion and fire out there. These guys are going to put on a show, but you're going to see the intensity that's never been seen before in any type of All-Star game.
You are a 6-time MVP, your 15th and final season. This is your last All-Star game. What do the next 2 hours mean to you?
It's just a pleasure to play with these young guys. These are the future of our league, and I'm just happy to be here with them to enjoy watching and play with them one last time, and then they're taking it to the next level.
What is the one thing that you want fans who are viewing this contest today to take away from this All-Star game?
I hope they see how much these guys love to play, and the fact they just play for the love of the game and passion, and they lay it all on the line every single night.
Good to see you, and have some fun.
I will. Thanks.
All right, Mike, let's go back up to you.
On the same floor at the start, with Gary Gate, all-time leading scorer, number 22 in black, and number 11, John Tavares of Buffalo, in white. Chet Couture is the crew chief, Rick Lum, the assistant referee, and Maurice Getz is the technical official. Those are the three men in charge of the game. The technical official is the man who stands near the benches and just makes sure that the line changes, which can occur on the fly, take place properly. You expect a quick start here?
Yes, for sure. And you touched on it in the opening, Mike, but these guys will play like an intensity that you never seen in an All-Star game. Both teams want to win badly. Both teams want to put on a great show.
First shot on goal is by Gary Gate. 30-second shot clock. It only resets with a change of possession or with a shot that is on goal. It must be stopped by the goalie, or if it hits the post, it counts as a shot on goal. Otherwise, the clock continues to go, as it will on that shot. But it's picked up and handled by Peter Luck of the Arizona Sting. Run back ahead now by Gelsvik. A little pass in front, and that one went sailing wide. Good collision on the boards. And it's possession now to the east.
That was a nice shot by Prout, just missed. You're going to see a lot of these over-the-shoulder shots. These guys are very good at shooting behind their back, in front, below. They've got all kinds of techniques for scoring and shooting.
The first goal last year in the All-Star game occurred at the half-minute mark. We have gone past that already. Jay Jalbert with an opening. Save made in front of getting a piece of that with Pat O'Toole from the Rochester Nighthawks. And a cherry pick pass in front. Little trouble handling, though, and a crossover backhander shot that sailed wide from the stick of Colin Doyle.
That was a sneaky little play by Colin Doyle. He saw Jalbert had a scoring chance on the one end, so he thought he wasn't going to catch him. He snuck down on the other end, hoping for the save. Got the save, but didn't score the goal.
Dan Teague bedded in front. He was hoping for a connection with Doyle again, but it's picked up for the goalkeeper, Anthony Cosmo, and a long pass ahead is brought back on by Ryan Boyle. Boyle circling, taking some repeated checks, as you will see often in the afternoon. Why these guys don't wheel around and deck somebody, I don't know.
Yeah, well, you know, they grow up playing that way. They're used to getting hammered and hacked. It's probably the only sport where you're given a rep and a stick and you're allowed to cross-check and slash.
Glenn Clark worked over pretty well by Gavin Prout of the West.
Black ball, of course, black ball. Heads up.
It's the West ball and a change on the fly from the East bench.
Often you'll see a call, a possession call for a push on a loose ball. You're allowed to hit anyone within 9 feet of the ball as long as it's from in front. If it's from behind, you'll see a possession call.
Lewis Ratcliffe couldn't get anything going. Calgary Roughneck representative, one of five from Calgary here. Colorado with five, San Jose with four, Arizona and Anaheim with two each on the West squad.
And Mike, unlike hockey, there's very few face-offs in this game.
Two great opportunities in front. The first from Mark Stainhouse. The second from Tom Marichek. Long pass ahead. Moving in and shooting. Score! Dan Dawson from the Arizona Sting. And at 1:31, make that 2:31 of the first period. The West has struck first.
And Dan Dawson, a starter for the West, is having a fantastic year. 28 goals, second best in the league. He comes off the bench early, and they take advantage of that. This guy was drafted 67th overall, only scored 3 goals as a rookie. They primarily used him on defense. When he got a chance to show his offense, there's been no looking back. He's the newest superstar in this league at only 23 years old.
Leads all of the Western Division scorers coming into today with 46 points. And the West back on the attack again, Gary Rosicky. Little feed in front, score! 2-0, very quick at the front of the goal.
Jalbert has got great talent on both ends of the floor. A lot of these guys are specialists playing offense or defense. He plays a bit of both. He just sees an opening, cuts to the net. Nice shot. We talked to him earlier about he's got a lot of field lacrosse experience. He said when he first started playing indoor lacrosse, he was shocked at how small the nets were, how big the goalies were. It took a bit of an adjustment, but he has adjusted. He's got more goals in this league than any defender, 12 goals in the regular season.
Chance in front, and that one stopped by O'Toole. Rebound, they score! It may seem like a deluge, but a 3-goal lead in lacrosse often can evaporate in the final minute of play.
Oh, really, 3 goals is nothing in lacrosse, and you're going to see this a lot off a faceoff. This was probably only 5 or 6 seconds. They won the faceoff. This is Jesse Phillips, who is another one of these great defensive players at scoring. He gets the shot, and the rebound comes out. Nice goal, big lead. Big lead, but a big lead is nothing. 3 goals is nothing in this sport.
Here they come again, and it's Moss not able to connect.
And I think Jim Moss just stepped into the crease there. That crease area is a protected area. The offensive player is not allowed to step in there. You could dive through if you're taking a shot, but you can't step in.
It's a 9-foot radius. The ball weighs 6 ounces heavier than a hockey puck. It can be shot over 100 miles an hour. That was just a little flip in front that was blocked off by the goaltender Anthony Cosmo. You would think that firing it at that range, 6 ounces of Indian rubber, would sting big time.
Well, the goaltenders wear a lot of equipment, but I've seen these guys with pads off after the game. They still are bruised.
Oh, and over the back shot that time that came from Gary Rosicky of San Jose's Stealth. Now Gary Gate. Leader all time, final All-Star game. Bedwin that is cut off, and the ball goes back over to the East.
That was a nice play by Gate, but a better pickoff by Dan Teague to read that play.
Here is Casey Powell. Bedwin in front, that ricocheted to the corner, is scooped up by Caleb Toth, the local man. Grew up here and played for the pro team after coming back from Toronto. To the outside now, Lewis Ratcliffe worked it on back to Powell again. Behind the back, and it came right in for an easy play by Pat O'Toole. And O'Toole with a long pass ahead that just glanced off of the stick of Jim Beltman.
And O'Toole can pass that ball. He got 4 assists in one game this year. He's got over 100 assists in his career in about 120 games. So he can throw that ball.
Here is Blaine Manning with a shot that glanced off the post. Rebound picked up, and looking ahead back down the carpet is Anthony Cosmo.
So far, Cosmo's been good, and he's got a little bit of help from the pipes. I think that first shot by Manning hit the post.
A little bit of a jostle on Moss, and we get a halt to play.
Broadband, you're ready to go. Call 1-800-964-4VON or visit Vonage.com. Also available at these fine retailers.
Lacrosse is one of the most physically demanding sports, and the players need fast rehydration. Aquas Rapid Response Rehydration is one of the most effective rehydration products in the world. Designed for the U.S. military and validated by some of the world's leading rehydration scientists, Aquas provides superior rehydration through advanced technology for direct absorption into the bloodstream. When you need rehydration fast, drink Aquas, the official energy drink of the National Lacrosse League. Available at madlax.com.
Take the dollar.
What's going on, man?
It won't take my dollar. Wow, that looks good.
Oh, yeah, it's new from KFC. Real chicken breast. Only a dollar.
You got that for a dollar?
Yeah. Took your dollar.
Oh.
Ready for a tasty bargain? Try the brand new 99-cent snacker from KFC. 100% hand-floured chicken breast, pepper mayo, and crisp lettuce freshly prepared on a sesame seed bun. Now your dollar goes further at KFC.
The 2005 National Lacrosse League All-Star Game is brought to you by Vonage, the broadband phone company. By Aquas, Rapid Response Rehydration, the official energy drink of the NLL. And by KFC's new 99-cent snacker. Now your dollar goes further at KFC. Downstairs to Mark Morgan and Dan Dawson.
Mike, thank you very much. Dan, you couldn't have been more wide open. What happened on that first goal?
Our D did a great job of moving it up the floor. I came hard off the bench and kind of dived and put her upstairs.
Quick lead for your squad. Is that something you guys talked about in the locker room, that, hey, an early jump in this game, though a 3-goal lead obviously in lacrosse is not a big lead, an early jump is important?
Yeah, you know, we wanted to come out the gates flying, and we've done that so far. Cosmo's shutting the door, and our offense is getting going early.
Thanks a lot.
No problem, guys.
Mike, back to you.
Okay. You will hear public address man Bruce Barker in the background with that big voice. He describes the game for the fans. That happens in the arenas. Music is a constant part of the Indoor Lacrosse League experience, too. 3-0 West. West on the attack. Denied of the ball for a moment was Caleb Toth, but he recovers. Hard shot by Gavin Prout of Colorado is blocked aside by Pat O'Toole.
Big save, and you see Glenn Clark got that rebound within the crease. He's in a protected area there. He can't bring the ball back into the crease, but if he catches there, nobody can check, but you have 10 seconds to get that out of your end.
Watch the bench.
Pulling a sneak play here, Mike.
It is sneaky. Yeah, the net is empty at the other end, and there's no delayed penalty call on. Ball fed back, and up with it is Prout, and so chucking back into the goal crease with all that healthy equipment is O'Toole.
That's something that you'll see in lacrosse every once in a while. They will pull the goalie, even though there's no delayed penalty. They will try to do it while the defenders are not looking towards that end to pull a sneak play to get an extra guy on. The defenders are playing man-to-man, and the guy sneaked down the floor wide open. It didn't work that time, but you'll see it a few times.
Tom Marichek from Philadelphia gives it across. Craig Kahn of Minnesota. It is rough. It is fed across from Manning. Oh, the return pass went by him. Blaine Manning from the Toronto Rock hangs on and then works it across. Oh, and a behind-the-back shot was stopped by Anthony Cosmo.
That was some pretty passing between Manning and Coyle. A little bit too pretty.
Jesse Phillips' shot is patted away by Pat O'Toole. Phillips again trying to get away from the checking of Glenn Clark. Mark and Jay Gilbert had one of the better battles last year in the All-Star game. Out in front, a quick stop made by O'Toole. He was the starter for the East in last year's game, played in Denver, and we get play stopped. 5:14 to go in the first period of this. It is Dawson Gilbert and a change on the third goal. Kolesky had that. 3-0 West.
To be the best, you have to learn from the best. How would you like to learn to shoot like Gary Gate? See the field like Ryan Boyle? Now you can. Through University of La Crosse, where hundreds of today's best players, coaches, and instructors are teaching high school players to be tomorrow's stars. Go to universitylacrosse.com and unleash the game.
It's an unfortunate fact of life that, according to the CDC, more than 33% of people aged 65 and older are involved in accidents and falls at home each year. Fortunately, help in regaining an active and independent lifestyle is just the push of a button away. A 24/7 monitored medical alarm system from Connect America provides peace of mind for only $29.95 per month. For more information, go to medicalalarm.com or call 1-800-906-0872.
Lead slinger Tony Graziani. His laser left arm and poise under pressure has Philly in a frenzy. Next up, a QB shootout fit for the Wild West as they host Cowboy Kid Clint Sterner and Dallas. Or Damian Hands Harrell in Colorado host Greg Hopkins and LA. The AFL on NBC, Sunday, 3 Eastern.
Welcome back to the 2005 NLL All-Star Game. I'm Mark Morgan along with Tracy Kolesky. Tracy, nice goal there. Good to hear the hometown fans, a little extra cheer for you, huh?
Yeah, definitely. Our crowd, we feel is the best in the league, and it's awesome to get them to get behind us.
Quick start from your team. We talked with Dan Dawson a moment ago. It was very important for this squad to jump out early. Why?
Yeah, definitely. I think a couple guys on their team had games last night, so we knew they were going to be a little tired, so we jump out to a quick lead, hopefully continue with it.
All right, good luck the rest of the game.
Thank you.
Mike?
Tracy Kolesky, who mans the telephones here in the Calgary office and occasionally calls people about season ticket renewals. They usually respond pretty well when a player calls.
Yeah, they do. They're often shocked in the head. It takes a little bit of convincing before they believe that it's their star player calling them for season ticket renewals.
Three goals in the span of 27 seconds. 3-0 the West. Not much scoring lately, though. And here is Gilbert. Jay Gilbert bringing it ahead. Long pass of beauty! Shot was right on from Toth and stopped by O'Toole.
That's one of the most exciting things about this game, Mike, is that a defender will run straight to the bench, an offensive guy will come off and give that 30-yard or 30-feet head start, and you'll get a lot of breakaways that way. These defenders can pass that ball hard and fast.
What a rocket from Colin Doyle that was stopped by Cosmo, trying to fight free, and a good over-the-back shot by Tom Marichek, and Cosmo got that and an over-the-back pass ahead.
And that pass was on the money, too. Jesse Phillips just couldn't handle it.
Long toss ahead, and that one deflected away by the big defense person, Pat Coyle. You like defenders, other people like defensemen. That's a combination, sort of. Sorry.
Defenders, defensemen, transition players, that's used a lot because a lot of these guys have great speed. They will go from defense straight on offense. This game has evolved a little bit over the last few years where you've got a lot of specialists. Some guys that just play strictly offense, some guys that play strictly defense. And then you get a few that play both ways.
Marichek's toss was blocked away by Anthony Cosmo. Talked earlier about the heft of the ball and how it must sting. But I guess the bigger problem are the sticks.
Yeah, a lot of new fans will say that ball must hurt. You have to worry about the stick more than the ball. You rarely get hit from the ball as a player. A goaltender does, of course.
Oh, here's Manning, a shot right at the edge of the crease, and that one blocked away by Cosmo. They outlet it ahead, and it is Gavin Prout from Colorado. Mammoth player hands it across. Oh, good combination. Another shot wide. Gary Gate.
I'll tell you, both goaltenders have been playing really well.
Oh, here's a lead pass and a beauty across. Hard shot by Mark Stainhouse. It's blocked aside by Cosmo. Stainhouse up with it again. Wheels with it. Knocked off his stick. Scooped up again and sent back over by Thomas Hayek of Philadelphia.
Oh, and I don't know if you noticed there, Cosmo came out and took the hit. When the goaltender steps out of the crease, he's fair game.
Locked the gate. Save made in front. Getting a piece of another tool. Another backhander, and that one is stopped. Shot clock is back at 30 again. Over the back shot off the glass by Gate. Fed back across once more. And it is Lewis Ratcliffe with a shot that's turned aside. Ratcliffe, another one of the Calgary Roughnecks in this lineup today. The guys with the big rings to wear. On now comes the East, looking for that first goal. The pass broken up, and a long lead was just away from Jesse Phillips. And play is stopped. 2 minutes and 17 seconds to go. First period of the contest, my partner chuckles, has been pretty good so far.
No shortage of action and great goaltending both ends.
Play halted here in Calgary.
Take the dog.
What's going on, man?
It won't take my dollar. Wow, that looks good.
Oh, yeah, it's new from KFC. Real chicken breast. Only a dollar.
You got that for a dollar?
Yeah. I took your dollar.
Oh.
Ready for a tasty bargain? Try the brand new 99-cent snacker from KFC. 100% hand-floured chicken breast, pepper mayo, and crisp lettuce freshly prepared on a sesame seed bun. Now your dollar goes further at KFC.
Hi, I'm Gary Gate of the Colorado Mammoth. Do you want to separate yourself from the pack? If you're a high school lacrosse player, the National Developmental Program is a series of high school lacrosse tournaments for boys and girls that will showcase your talents to college coaches. These tournaments are designed to provide you with an extensive learning opportunity to sharpen your skills and help you show college coaches what you can do. Parents and coaches, NDP is the best, most cost-effective way to manage your kids' college search. NDP, building your college lacrosse future today. Separate yourself from the pack at ndplacrosse.com.
Unstoppable AQ Mega Ride from Adidas, exclusively at Finish Line.
Monday, CSI Miami's a repeat, but you can catch an all-new medium. The drama America's talking about.
This is a dream I shouldn't ignore.
Patricia Arquette is sensational.
Mom?
In TV Guide's Hot Show for Monday. All-new medium, NBC Monday.
The job that seemingly not many people watching this game want to have.
Well, that's a tough job, and Pat O'Toole is one of the best. This is his 11th year in this league. He won a championship in his rookie year in Buffalo, and he's been to the championship three times since. Cosmo has won two championships for Toronto. He was primarily a backup goaltender there, but he was rated probably the best backup in the league. Got traded to San Jose in the offseason and has had a great year, great enough to be elected as a starter to the All-Star game.
Why is the East goaltender at the bench?
Well, with Eddie Como and Paul Day on the bench, they like pulling their goalies. They like tricking the other team whenever they can. Sometimes it's a fake play, sometimes it's a sneak play.
And Teat defended away, but stripped of his stick was Pat Coyle. He hands it across behind the back pass, and Sean Williams with one that deflected to the glass. Thrown in front, they try for Williams again, but it's bagged by the defense and sent the other way. Hustling ahead is Jesse Phillips. He's got a man free. He's got it around in front. Tool on the shot by Dan Dawson trying for his second.
Oh, and Pat O'Toole made that look easy. Dan Dawson kind of faked the over the shoulder. He scored the opening goal, but I'm surprised that this East team hasn't scored yet with John Grant, John Tavares. Cosmos played great, but it's a matter of time before they're going to put one in.
Colin Doyle with a ripping shot. Another feed in front. It's score! It's a matter of time.
That's right. But John Tavares, you know, it can only hold these guys off the score sheet for so long. John Tavares, over 1,000 points, the only other player besides Gary Gate to score 1,000 points. He's just a few goals away from his 500th. Only Gary Gate has 500 goals. He just cuts to the net. Nice pass. You'll see a few more from Tavares and Grant.
A battle in the corner, and Cosmo is going to have to hustle back. Hasn't gotten there yet, so taking his place in the goal was Peter Luck. And Luck eventually comes up with this loose ball.
I love when the goaltenders come out to play the loose balls. I talked about Pat O'Toole having over 100 assists. I forgot to mention he scored two goals in this league as well.
Time of the goal, 10 minutes.
So the goalie fault strategy, either late in a game or in mid-game, sometimes fails. Here is Gary Rosicky. Behind the back shot was wide, dug out though by Dan Dawson. Arizona Sting player gives it to the back and then on across once more. And the shot clock expired, and so in the final 29 seconds of this period, the East with one more chance.
Yeah, you'll see the referee patting on his head once in a while. That means the shot clock violation, 30 seconds, has expired. There's also a 10-second rule. You have to get it out of your end within 10 seconds.
Goaltender pulled here. Six attackers against a goalie and five for the East. Tavares with a little feed, a no-look pass in front. It's kicked aside, oh, and then shoveled wide on a neat pass by Colin Doyle across. Long toss to the empty net, and it goes wide, and the horn will sound. Entertaining first period. The West with three goals and the East with one. We will be back with the second quarter of our contest today. Four quarters in lacrosse. We hope you're enjoying it.
Now you can have a front row seat at the greatest rock performances of all time. Hendrix at Woodstock. The Who at Monterey. The Stones on the Ed Sullivan Show. Time Life Video proudly presents The History of Rock. Now available for the first time on DVD.
How many more times?
This incredible collection includes all the legends of rock. Plus, you'll get rare behind-the-scenes footage, bonus features, and stories you've never heard before. Call now to own the history of rock. More than 4 hours of legendary performances on two DVDs for just $16.99 each. But wait, there's more. Call with your credit card and get a third DVD absolutely free. That's right, a $16.99 value absolutely free. This is the first time all the classic rock legends are together in one DVD collection. Over 120 performances digitally remastered on three DVDs. And it's not available in stores. So call with your credit card now and get over 120 live performances on three DVDs for just two installments of $16.99. Call now.
Call 1-800-642-7648 to order The History of Rock and Roll for two installments of just $16.99 plus shipping and handling, and receive a third volume free when you use your credit card. Call now or order online at timelife.com.
Hooray for Hollywood with Christy Yamaguchi, Brian Boitano, Elvis Stoiko, plus Michael Bolton. A tribute to Movies on Ice, Sunday, 1 Eastern, NBC.
West. Second quarter will be getting underway shortly. To vote for the 2005 NLL All-Star MVP, you can text message star 47467. So you can help pick the star of the game from this bevy of stars, 16 runners and two goaltenders per side. And the star you choose will get a flat screen TV. Shot ricocheted off the pipe. Gary Gate could not come up with that.
All right, some of these turnovers, the fans at home might not be sure, but that one was called for a push on the back. The referee will generally point in the direction that the ball should be going. Often you'll see illegal picks. You can set a pick, but you can't. You have to be stationary when you do, and you can't bump a player when you pick, although these guys get away with it as much as they can. The rule in lacrosse is cheat if you can get away with it.
Oh. Now moving ahead is John Grant. Grant, still moving in front, he scores! Oh, you can see what has made this Rochester Nighthawk the leading point getter in the league, John Grant.
Well, we were talking earlier, how long can you hold these great scorers off on the East? John Tavares starts it off, and John Grant, did you see him fake that over the shoulder? He is so good with his stick. Watch as he comes around the top. He gets a big fake on the over the shoulder. It froze the defender for a second. He can shoot all sorts of ways. He's the best stick man in the league. All the players will tell you that.
Moving ahead, Hayek. Long toss on, and the over-the-back shot went wide from Barachek, and another shot, and that one is blocked away by Anthony Cosmo. Teams have changed ends. West attacking from the right to the left on your screen this quarter. And it is Tavares.
Now, that was not called for over and back because it was the defender was the one who actually pushed the ball back.
Barachek with another shot and diving out to eventually cover is Cosmo. And so the ball back to the West. Let's check out the coaches here.
Well, that's actually Paul Day, coaches for the Rochester Nighthawks. His team was in first place when the teams were picked. He's been coaching Rochester since 98. They've made the playoffs every year. He's gone to the championship three times, unfortunately. Met up with the Toronto Rock each time, but he's got one of the best coaching records in the league.
Juggling play made by O'Toole. Looks ahead for his options. He's got Mike Hazen.
And Chris Hall has been coaching Calgary from day one. This is their fourth year in the league. First year, they were a tough season as an expansion team. 4-12 last year. They ended up winning the championship. Great season. Got great support by Calgary. And he's done a great job coaching these guys.
Over and back on this, but the time is expiring to get it back ahead. And a pass is snagged and brought on by Gavin Prout. So Prout feeds one across. Jesse Phillips with it there. A couple of whacks from John Grant. Early stages, second quarter of our all-star game telecast, the National Lacrosse League, left behind by Toth, and it's picked up and brought ahead by Stainhouse. Moving on in, he got six in the game last year, and his pass across floated away from Colin Doyle. So Doyle might have been expecting a shot rather than pass. Long pass ahead and fighting his way in, but unable to get a shot away with Rosicki. He gets it back and whips one that is held by O'Toole.
I think Doyle was expecting a pass possibly, but Stainhouse gave him the reverse over the shoulder pass. I think it fooled Doyle.
Jim Veltman from Toronto plays it ahead, and here is Sean Williams. Williams firing, and that one just calmly blocked away, and then traced down by Cosmo. He got a little bit of help, and he certainly needed it from Peter Luck. Pass squirts ahead, but is flagged down and brought on further by Chris Seller. Fed one across, and the shot deflected up into the mesh above the glass, and so the ball goes over. That guy was nicknamed the Axe, Jim Moss. All a part of how he uses his stick. Occasionally scores too. His team ahead by one.
Broadband, you're ready to go. Call 1-800-934-4VON or visit Vonage.com. Also available at these fine retailers.
To be the best, you have to learn from the best. How would you like to learn to shoot like Gary Gate? See the field like Ryan Boyle? Now you can. Through University Lacrosse, where hundreds of today's best players, coaches, and instructors are teaching high school players to be tomorrow's stars. Go to universitylacrosse.com and unleash the game.
Lacrosse is one of the most physically demanding sports, and the players need fast rehydration.
Aquas Rapid Response Rehydration is one of the most effective rehydration products in the world. Designed for the U.S. military and validated by some of the world's leading rehydration scientists, Aquas provides superior rehydration through advanced technology for direct absorption into the bloodstream. When you need rehydration fast, drink Aquas, the official energy drink of the National Lacrosse League. Available at madlax.com.
The 2005 National Lacrosse League All-Star Game is brought to you by Bonnie, the broadband phone company. By KFC's new 99-cent snacker. Now your dollar goes further at KFC. And by Aquas, Rapid Response Rehydration, the official energy drink of the NLL. Well, here in Calgary, see this brilliant carpet beneath us from way up high here.
They actually put that carpet down right on the ice. So they'll roll that carpet off after the game and people will be playing hockey here.
Calgary Junior Hitmen played hockey last night, defeating Red Deer 5-2. Red Deer about 100 miles from here. If you come from that far and run into a guy, you can be called for charging. That's a 2-minute penalty. Shorter than Red Deer, sometimes they'll let it go. Here's Prout moving in. Shakes off a check. Prout is in, he scores! What a play!
Great effort by Gavin Prout, the star from Colorado. It was another first round number one draft choice. Just watch this second effort here. As he's falling, he just hesitates for another second, and that's what gets him the goal. Pat O'Toole steps out to block the angle. He thinks he's shooting as he falls. That last hesitation allows him to put on one more fake.
Casey Powell moving in here. One of the three Powell brothers out of Syracuse University. Two of them playing in the league, and one might be in another year. Drafted by San Jose. The former two are both playing for Anaheim. Both Casey and Ryan. Mike was the third pick and the second rounder from San Jose in this past summer's draft. Williams speeds one across. Bouncer unable to come up with that. It was Blaine Manning, and so back ahead on the attack. Now the West with the two-goal lead. Hard shot right on goal. Chris Seller let that go. And a long pass ahead is taken by Mike Hazen.
Watch the door!
Out of Rochester, feeding it on back now to Sean Williams.
I'm here.
Very deliberate right now. Plenty of time on the shot clock. Middle stages of the second quarter of our game. The West ahead by a count of 4-2.
I don't know if you can hear that on television, but I heard the referees scream at the team to watch the door. The teams are starting to cheat a little bit to get that fast break. They will cheat as much as they can until they get called.
Well, the door across at the east bench, actually both doors were open while the east was on the attack just now.
Often you will see those doors will not close all the way and you'll get the warning. They're swinging open and closed so quickly that sometimes the coach will just leave it open a little bit.
Well, Koleski has one of the goals today scored by the West. Hard shot, oh, and sealing it, and then seeing it pop loose was O'Toole. Long toss by O'Toole, just wide. Stainhouse was the breaking runner that time for the East. Long pass ahead, and that one went off the noggin of Kyle Cooley.
Jim Veltman was wide open there, and I don't think Dan Teat saw him as he picked up that loose ball. Veltman was up the floor.
Here is Clark. Another change on the fly for the East. Here's John Grant. One goal already. Nice feet in front. Oh, and diving and scoring on the pass was Tom Marichak. Oh, it looked like he had nothing, and then he had everything.
Well, it was a nice pass, over-the-shoulder pass by John Grant. Marichak originally fumbled the pass, but he made up for it as he reached into the crease and put it in. You can't step into that crease, but you can reach in if there's a ball there and put it in the net. You can dive through if you want. Great second effort after he originally fumbled it.
Here is Prout beating it across, and the shot shoveled wide by Chris Seller of Anaheim. Little feet across and turning with this, trying to get loose was Lewis Ratcliffe of Calgary. Playing for the West here, they have a narrow one-goal lead. Middle stages, second quarter. Head across to Caleb Toth. Toth the shot, and it went wide. He won the hardest shot competition in Denver at the All-Star Game last year with a blast of 99 miles an hour. Fastest on record for him, he said he was younger then, was 106. His team's ahead by one.
Take the dog.
What's going on, man?
It won't take my dollar. Wow, that looks good.
Oh, yeah, it's new from KFC. Yeah. Real chicken breast. Only a dollar.
You got that for a dollar?
Yeah. Took your dollar.
Oh.
Ready for a tasty bargain? Try the brand new 99-cent snacker from KFC. 100% hand-floured chicken breast, pepper mayo, and crisp lettuce freshly prepared on a sesame seed bun. Now your dollar goes further at KFC.
It's an unfortunate fact of life that, according to the CDC, more than 33% of people aged 65 and older are involved in accidents and falls at home each year. Fortunately, help in regaining an active and independent lifestyle is just the push of a button away. A 24/7 monitored medical alarm system from Connect America provides peace of mind for only $29.95 per month. For more information, go to medicalalarm.com or call 1-800-906-0872.
Tiger Woods, after an un-Tiger-like 04, his roar is back and the tour better look out. Phil Mickelson, sizzling hot with two wins this year. Vijay Singh, coming off last year's 9-win explosion. It's a lineup loaded with 9 of the top 10 stars, all looking to tame the Blue Monster. The Ford Championship at Doral. Coverage begins next Saturday, 3 Eastern, NBC.
Second quarter, West 4, East 3. We were talking earlier about Paul Day, Rochester Nighthawks coach. He has been accorded an award.
Yeah, last year he won the Coach of the Year Award, which is actually called the Les Bartley Award, that for the best coach has been awarded for 3 years now. But the ironic part is probably the best coach, Les Bartley, has never won it. He has taken his team to the championship 10 times, won it 7 times, and was unfortunately diagnosed with colon cancer last year, and he's undergoing treatment, and he's not in the greatest of health. I'm sure he's at home, and all these players love Les Bartley, and they're all hoping the best for him. And Paul has learned a lot from Les Bartley as well. His assistant coach, Eddie Como, coached with Les Bartley for years. Paul put him and his coaching staff really quickly when he got a chance.
Nice strip of the ball by Ryan Cousins of Minnesota, and the East goes back on the attack trying to tie. Pass just will not work, so to the outside it's Dan Teed from Buffalo. Playing for the East here. Good shot on goal by John Grant is stopped by Cosmo. And a long pass is brought back on and sent across for a shot that was stopped at the other end by Pat O'Toole, and he looks for the long pass. Decides to go for the shorter one. You think one of Paul Day's tricks that he learned from Les Bartley was pulling that goaltender and...
Absolutely.
Feet in front, score! Tying the game was the guy you said would get one, Colin Doyle.
Well, and didn't we say it was an early 3-0 lead? We said in lacrosse, 3-0, 3 goals is nothing, 4 goals is nothing. Now it's 4-all, and Colin Doyle, one of the best money players. He's won the championship 4 times with the Toronto Rock, has been the MVP twice, was the Rookie of the Year back in 98 for the Ontario Raiders. He can score.
Here is Cooling moving in, swatted one to the crease, jam up there, dug out and backhanded wide by Craig Kahn. Fed in front again, and a hurrying shot went up over the top of the cage from Kyle Cooling. Loose one in front. And the ball will belong to the East. Tie game late second quarter.
That ball is going back to the East because they claim, the referee says that the West actually brought the ball back into the crease. When it's out, you can't bring it back into that protected area. That's actually a new rule in the league this year, and I think it's a great one.
Very deliberately, John Grant trying to pull his way through. Still protecting and working. Shovels it off to Williams. A shot is blocked in front. Aside, Cosmo teaming up there with his teammate Peter Luck.
We're going to get our first penalty.
Here is Coyle on the delayed call. And the strategy here is to kind of hold things up a little bit.
Yeah, on the delayed call, you will always pull your goaltender for that extra man. They'll play a 6-on-5 here.
Go West, go is the chant from the fans here in Calgary. Ryan Boyle, a cross quick shot is stopped by O'Toole, and with that, we will get the penalty call.
It's a holding call. I think it might actually be John Grant. John Grant has been called. One of the many tricks John Grant has when he's on offense, he will often pull the defender who's covering him so that he loses his balance. It gets Grant open, and he gets caught at it. Now, I don't think that's actually the penalty. That ball was loose. He was going for the ball there.
The point man is Dawson, number six at the back. Good hard drive is blocked by O'Toole, and so the East has it. 30-second shot clock goes for them as well, so they are shorthanded, and a shot to goal! What a shot by Craig Kahn! Oh, man! 5-4 in favor of the East. They get the lead for the first time as Craig Kahn from the Minnesota Swarm hammers one. Play halted here, latter stages of the second quarter. In this All-Star game, the East now has the lead for the first time.
Do bulky storage containers set off an avalanche in your kitchen? Is finding a lid almost impossible? And why is shelf space at such a premium? What you need is the SmartSpin storage system. Now organize and store all your containers and lids in less than 1 square foot. Watch, turn any disaster into an organized master. SmartSpin conveniently holds all your storage needs right at your fingertips. Its unique patented design slides forward, then spins like a carousel for easy selection. You can even find a container and lid with a blindfold on. SmartSpin holds an enormous amount of food, yet takes up about the space of a coffee maker. It's perfect for any cabinet, drawer, shelf, or countertop. Just slide, spin, and store. Frustrated with messy foil and dripping bags? No problem. SmartSpin's locking lids are spill-proof, but open with the touch of a finger. And because one size lid fits all, you'll never go searching again. SmartSpin's clear containers let you see what's inside. And with three sizes, you can store virtually anything. They're smart for keeping leftovers fresh, organizing daily meals, or packing school lunches. Plus, they're microwavable and dishwasher safe. SmartSpin is the only compact storage system that slides, spins, and stores. You'll wonder how you ever got along without them. Call now and receive your SmartSpin carousel with 4 24-ounce containers, 4 16-ounce, 4 8-ounce, and 12 locking lids for just $19.99. But here's an even better deal. We'll double the containers and lids absolutely free. Now store nuts and bolts in the garage. Put one in the RV, boat, or office, anywhere space is limited. SmartSpin is guaranteed to give you more shelf, cabinet, and countertop space or your money back. That means you get the complete 49-piece storage system that can fit in less than 1 square foot, all yours for just $19.99. Here's how to order.
Call 1-800-658-7805 and order your SmartSpin storage system for $19.99 plus $7.95 shipping and handling. Organize and store all of your containers and lids. Call now. Must be 18 or older to order.
This summer, you can do it yourself, or you can go pro. This is the slam. The Do Action Sports Tour. Coming June to NBC.
Coming up at halftime, Dan Hicks will bring you all the latest sports news as well as a special look at the National Lacrosse League's most famous player, Gary Gate. That's coming up at halftime from our NBC studio.
This is Gary Gate's 15th season, and you know, since his first year in 1991, no one has won the scoring title other than a Gate or Tavares. He also had his twin brother, Paul, who won a couple in there, but Gary Gate, John Tavares, Paul Gate are the only ones who have won it in the last 14 seasons.
Our play is continuing here for the West, but the East, though shorthanded and having scored a shorthanded goal from Craig Kahn, now see it go back to the West. So here is Koleski. Fed one in front, score!
Gary Gate
right on cue, game tied at 5.
Well, generally you'll see the shorthanded team set up the box and a power play to set up and wait for them. But that time the short man team, the East, was slow to get ready, so Gate just cut to the net, saw his opening and just overpowered his guys. And although Gate's often compared to Wayne Gretzky, that's more for how he has sold the sport of lacrosse. He plays more of a style, probably close to Mario Lemieux in his prime. He could just overpower guys with his size, his speed, but then he has the great hands of a small guy.
Speaking of Gretzky, former lacrosse player himself, box lacrosse player in Canada and involved with the Arizona Sting at the Glendale Arena. Eight of the 10 teams are owned by NHL or NBA squads or by the arenas in which they play.
Quite a few NHLers involved. My brother Brendan is a part owner of the Toronto Rock. Owen Nolan is a part owner of the San Jose team.
Couple of good stops by goaltenders, one at either end. Is Brendan coming back, by the way, to play for Toronto?
Well, he practiced with him, and I didn't want to call him and ask him shortly after the NHL season was in. It's like asking somebody after somebody has just died what they're going to do next. So give him a bit of time, but I would not be shocked.
All right, it's worked in for a back shot and a rebound. Oh, and a great stop by Pat O'Toole on the rebound attempt from Kulusky. Penalty time is up. Little under a minute and a quarter to go in the half, and a shot sails wide from Dan Teat. Bounces right back and charging ahead with it now for the West. Protecting pretty well is Jesse Phillips. Ryan Boyle, the only rookie in the game. Shot came screaming in on Pat O'Toole and popped up in the air high. That from Chris Seller of Anaheim. East back on the attack again. Glenn Clark brings it ahead. Clark a shot, and the bouncer was well off the mark. 42 to go. Nice swagger move there by Thomas Hayek of Philadelphia. But it's thrown ahead, and coming way out of his goal is O'Toole to grab it. Oh. And it was nearly turned back over as drifting near O'Toole was Thomas Hayek, but now right back in they come again, and a shot score! Dan Teat!
Nice goal by Dan Teat, one of the most underrated players in this league, but the play that made it was the pass by Tom Marichuk. And it also started from Jim Veltman, who got the loose ball, passed to the guy coming off the bench, but Marichuk froze the defender with that over-the-shoulder pass, and Teat made no mistake. Teat likes playing here. He scored six goals against the Calgary team last year in a 19-12 win.
On a shot, and the rebound ricocheted off of Cosmo. Chances are both teams will change goaltenders for the second half. Gene Ash and Dallas Elliott likely to be in for the second half as the horn sounds to end the second quarter. Oh, good first half of play. Back and forth it went. The East eventually got the lead and reclaimed it on the goal by Dan Teat in the final 30 seconds. So the score at the end of the first half of our game from Pengrowth Saddle Dome in Calgary, the National Lacrosse League All-Star Game, it's 6-5 East. Let's join Dan Hicks in our NBC studio in New York.
This is the NBC Sports Update. Here's Dan Hicks.
And hi, everybody. Welcome to our New York studio. As you saw at the half, the East leads the West 6-5. Now, the West team's captain, Gary Gate, may seem familiar to some of you. Along with his twin brother, Paul, Gary led Syracuse to three straight NCAA lacrosse titles from 1988 to 1990. He finished as the school's all-time leading scorer, then moved on to the National Lacrosse League, where he's continued to impress, winning the league's MVP trophy a record six times. Gate, though, has announced that this season will be his last.
One of the great all-time players, Gary Gate. Move in and score, and that's Mr. Gate. Who else?
Oh, my God. Great move by Gary Gate.
Started playing lacrosse at age four simply because my parents, I have an identical twin brother, Paul, and we used to wear them out. So in order to try and wear us out, they said, we got to put them in a sport or get them doing something really active.
Okay, with the great shot!
I think it's the passion for the game and the love to compete that really has allowed me to last this long. So I'm out there performing, but it's more for myself to prove that I can still do it. And I know physically I'm not the same player I was five, six, 7 years ago. So you got to do it other ways. That comes from inside, wanting to prove that you can still play and that you have a game.
Gary Gate, the greatest offensive force ever in this league.
It's pretty easy not to take it like this is my last game when you got one goal you're focused on. I look at it as if, you know, we're here to win a championship. You know, that's the dream scenario when you retire, is go out on top.
Oh, man, Gary Gate just keeps on coming.
I just want to be remembered as a player that had a true passion and love for the game and wanted to give back and help grow it.
The 37-year-old Gate, who is calling it quits after 15 seasons, will leave owning nearly every single record in league history. What a career. Coming up after lacrosse, it's gymnastics, the American Cup presented by TJ Maxx. And for a quick preview, we send it out just across the way to our man, Al Trotwick on Long Island. Al?
Eastern Time live coverage of the 34th Cup from the Nassau Veterans Memorial Coliseum. I'm joined by Tim Daggett, Elfie Schlegel, and Andrea Joyce in a sport that is undergoing tremendous change and controversial change to many.
Well, you know, the judging in Athens, Al, at the last Olympic Games, frankly, it was an embarrassment. I went back and I tried to think of all of the problems, how many times I thought the judges got it so wrong, and I lost count. And what they have done, the FIG, which is the governing body of gymnastics, they've had this huge knee-jerk reaction, and what it comes down to is you could very well see the elimination. I think it is gone. There is no 10.0 anymore in the sport of gymnastics after 2005.
You're looking live at Alexander Artemov of Team USA, a Russian dream, part of an American future, perhaps. And Elfie, on the women's side, the same thing. Nastia Liukin, are we about to see the next queen of American gymnastics?
Quite possibly. Marta Karoly says that this is a huge event for her. It's her senior debut. Let's see how she handles the pressure of this type of competition. It runs in her family. Her father, who coaches her, Valery Liukin, an 88 Olympic gold medalist. Her mother, a world champion in rhythmic gymnastics. You know, she's got all the goods. It could happen for her.
So we will not have all-around champions. We will have champions in each of the different events, four for the women, six for the men. It's all part of our live coverage of the 31st Visa American Cup, the most important annual gymnastics event on the American gymnastics calendar. Dan?
Thank you, Al. We look forward to the gymnastics in just a bit. That'll do it now from our studio. We send you back now to Calgary for the second half of the lacrosse game right after these messages.
They've come from across America.
My father's a doctor with the Navy, and he's in Afghanistan right now.
But they have one thing in common, the desire to be a champion.
I love you.
It's about love, dignity, and the courage to go far beyond what you think your own limits are.
From the producer of The Apprentice and Survivor, The Contender premieres next Monday after Fear Factor.
This week, a lucky Wheel Watchers Club member could win a trip to see the beautiful castles and coastlines of Ireland. If we call your number, you could win, so sign up at wheeloffortune.com.
Want to win? Get your spin.
Wheel of Fortune, Monday at 6:30 on your NBC Action News station.
Hello, everybody. I'm NBC Action Sports Director Jack Harry. Join me every Sunday night at 10:25 for the Heartland Bank Sports Sunday.
Sports Sunday is brought to you by Heartland Bank, located at Town Center Plaza.
This shoe is half off, and so are over 8,000 other pair during our women's half-off back rack sale, now in progress at Bob Jones Shoes, 19th and Grand, downtown.
We get everybody fits.
In all of Kansas City, there is no place with the selection of Dave Smith, the lamp maker, always providing the most interesting styles and lamps, traditional, oriental, distinctive, and always in step with the decorating times. Dave's experienced staff can help you choose just the right new shade for your favorite lamp. And when it comes time to lamp repair, everyone comes to Dave Smith, the lamp maker. For lamps, lampshades, decor accents, and professional lamp repair, there's just one leading lighting store in Kansas City. Dave Smith, the lamp maker, 7432 Warnham, where decorating ideas are just a shade better.
This is your NBC Action News Station, the home of Jeopardy.
gorgeous city at the foothills of the Rockies, Calgary, Alberta, Canada, site of the 2005 National Lacrosse League All-Star Game. The East ahead 6-5 at halftime. Jim Jennings, the commissioner, is here. What do you think of the game?
This is a great game. I tell you, you know, these guys play so hard, and it's unbelievable. The greatest players in the world, and they're hitting out there. You would never know it was an All-Star Game. Unbelievable.
Jim, you've had great success with some new teams, particularly Colorado and the ownership group. I know they own the basketball team, the hockey team, and the arena, and Minnesota as well. Is that the kind of ownership group that you'd like to get into this league?
Absolutely. I mean, we came in about 3 years ago and decided that we just wanted NHL, NBA owners, and that seems to really take our league to the next level. These are the guys. These are the type of owners we want. Stan Kroenke out in Colorado owns the Avalanche, and he owns the Denver Nuggets and owns the arena. Those type of people is what we're moving towards, and we're hoping to get a 16-team league here within the next 3 or 4 years.
Go ahead.
I was going to say, obviously, there are thoughts of continued expansion.
Absolutely. I mean, we're looking at key markets. We have some NHL, NBA owners that want to come in and partner with some local investors. And that's normally what we do. We may bring in some local investors, but the NHL, NBA owners are really the guys that do all the business operations and run the team.
And you have a chance to know a number 99 from the hockey world that's involved in lacrosse, too, Wayne Gretzky.
It's great. Wayne's a great owner. He owns our team out in Arizona. He also owns the Phoenix Coyotes, and we're thrilled to have him on. He came on as an owner last year, and that franchise is doing great. They're up about 300% on season ticket sales this year, and that's really going to be a great market for us.
I think the greatest market that you have is the men who play your game. My goodness, good bunch of guys.
These guys are unbelievable. I'm so proud to be the commissioner and oversee this league with these individual players. They work so hard. They're so smart, and they're a class act, really are.
Yeah, they have labor peace, too, going on, and all a part of the four-month schedule of 16 games, then leading into three rounds of playoffs. All a part of the excitement that we feel here in Calgary today, because we have a 6-5 lead for the East. The first half has been played, and so there are two more quarters to go. We hope you're enjoying this. We are. It's presented by Toshiba, the 2005 NLL All-Star Game, the East against the West. Players are now coming on for the start of the second half of this contest. Did you ever play yourself?
No, I never played. And I had success in business operations with basketball teams, minor league basketball teams, and started my start with the New York Cosmos back in the early 80s. And, you know, I think they wanted somebody that didn't play lacrosse that came in with a clear business mind.
Let's check in downstairs with Mark Morgan. Mark, who have you?
Mark, I have Colin Doyle here, and you were walking off at halftime going, hey, we're back in it, we're back in it. You guys dug a little hole, but now you are back in it.
Yeah, they got off to an early start, but Patty kept us in late. We got a few breaks offensively, so I think if we can keep coming at them, maybe get the first one this half and roll from there.
Give me a key for the second half for you guys to come away winners.
Get off the floor and not give them too many fast break opportunities.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Mike?
Well, Dallas Eliuk has come on to tend the nets for the East. As you see, the man in charge of the West, G. Nash, from the Colorado Mammoth.
G. Nash has transformed the Colorado team from a high-powered offense with little regard to defense as one of the best defensive teams in the league. They've got everything in place to win a championship. All they have to do is do it now.
Mentioned that Dallas Eliuk is in the cage, the Philadelphia Wings goalkeeper for 15 years. Gary Gate, a 15-year man. Tavares, a 14-year man. Jim Veltman, 13. A lot of long-timers. Many of them have not changed cities in that time either.
No, nobody has played for one team as long as Dallas Eliuk. He's been, as you said, 15 years with Philadelphia. And he's won four championships with that team. He was the MVP twice in the championship. One of the best goaltenders. He's a real reaction goalie. Great reflexes. Not a big guy, but he can fly.
The East back on the attack, going from right to left in this third quarter. And the East in the midst of a change on the fly. Sean Williams fed it across. Fed over now for control by Tom Marichek. Marichek took some punishment, but keeps going. Marichek up behind the backer, and that one sailed wide.
Here comes the West.
The West on the attack now. A shot went wide, a hard drive from Gavin Prout, and it comes all the way back near G. Nash.
Now that one will be called over and back because that shot didn't deflect off any defender, went straight out off the rebound.
All All-Star game with 11 goals scored here in the first half. The average for a game is 25. These games used to be more lopsided when there weren't really skilled defensive players on the All-Star teams, but they have that now.
You're absolutely right. I think it was a great move. At one point, they just put the big scorers on the All-Star games. It's hard to appreciate the goal when the defense isn't as strong, but right now, these great offensive players are playing against the toughest and the best defenders.
Well, one of those, Jim Moss, was there as Pat Coyle just came off of the carpet for a change. And here's a move by Dawson and went crashing in. The net dislodged, but the good stop by Dallas Elliott.
And you'll see that quite a bit. If you're going to try to dive through the crease, often you might get hit before you make that dive. There's a good chance you're running into a goaltender or the post.
Mark Stainhouse's shot deflected right back. Charging on with it now and holding his Gilbert, but then it is lobbed all the way down and eventually controlled and worked back on by Marichek. Marichek across, unable to take the pass, was Colin Doyle. I have Ron Gilbert in this game a minute ago. Here's Phillips moving in, and that one is grabbed off by Dallas Elliott, or is it Bernie Perron?
I see how quickly Elliott made that save and got the ball into his stick and up the floor.
Marichek, oh, a good fake, and he threw it on the forehand in front, and a splendid save made by Gene Ash.
And Marichek, who has been playing in this league since 94, is the third all-time career points leader.
Oh, good one-time attempt that came there from Jim Moss, but it went off the crossbar. Moss, big number 55, has peeled off now behind the net, takes the pass, and Moss in front, he scores! It's a tie game as Jim Moss is connected to make it 6-6.
And Jim Moss, usually a defender, is playing a bit of offense here. He's only got two goals this year because he's mostly in his own end, but he has good offensive skills, and I think it helped him that the net was off. It might have fooled Elliott, and that's the way the game goes. If the net's off, they play it. As long as that ball crosses the plane, it's still a goal.
East on the attack now, Kyle Cooley. Not much generated there, and so it's Craig Kahn who had that hard shot earlier, wanting to get another one away, but decides to feed it cross. Behind the back, it's bounced over for Sean Williams, who takes over. Williams from Rochester, a feed in front.
2 minutes, 48 seconds. For the West, they will battle
three against one. The East has the ball still up for grabs, and eventually the loose ball taken by the West. Loose ball is a very important statistic in lacrosse. Jim Veltman seems to own that statistic as a shot goes in from Jesse Phillips. It is the West 7 and the East 6.
Jesse Phillips, one of the best defenders in the league, plays for the hometown Calgary team, fakes the pass and goes short side.
Play stopped here midway in the third quarter. From Calgary, it's the hometown West 7 and the East 6.
Broadband, you're ready to go. Call 1-800-925-4VON or visit Vonage.com. Also available at these fine retailers.
Won't take my dollar. Wow, that looks good.
Oh yeah, it's new from KFC. Real chicken breast. Only a dollar.
You got that for a dollar?
Yeah. Took your dollar.
Oh.
Ready for a tasty bargain? Try the brand new 99-cent snacker from KFC. 100% hand-floured chicken breast, pepper mayo, and crisp lettuce freshly prepared on a sesame seed bun. Now your dollar goes further at KFC.
The 2005 National Lacrosse League All-Star Game is brought to you by Vonage, the broadband phone company. by Aquas, Rapid Response Rehydration, the official energy drink of the NLL. By KFC's new 99-cent snacker. Now your dollar goes further at KFC. And by University Lacrosse. Go to universitylacrosse.com and unleash the game. Downstairs to Mark Morgan.
Mike, Jim Moss a few moments ago with a nice goal. He told me prior to this game, when he found out that this contest was going to be nationally broadcast on NBC, he said to his fiance, I will do everything I have to do to get in that game because this is history. Obviously, Moss very proud of the goal he scored in this forum. Also, he's got to be proud of the fact that he said he covered Gary Grant three of the last four regular season games prior to the All-Star break. He held the legend to only three total goals, so he was fired up about that as well.
Pretty interesting. Pat Coyle gives this one across to Gavin Prout. And now Coyle will come to the bench in a change, and so also will Moss.
Well, Jimmy Moss was the defender of the year in 2003, two seasons ago. One of the best defenders in this league, so no surprise he's in this All-Star game, and he was picked as a starter.
Well, Jim was very proud of his nickname, the Axeman, too, you can tell that. Here is Gate getting in front on what a backhand attempt, but it doesn't find the red light going on. And what have we? Play back on, and it's the East on the attack. Moving on in is Hayek, and a save is made by Nash.
Ball goes back to the West. Hayek ran through the crease after that shot.
There have been some hockey references. Hayek, the former captain of the University of Vermont hockey team, as well as a lacrosse player there.
Absolutely right. Quite a few of these guys are multi-sport athletes. And Hayek, just his second year in the NLL as the captain of the Philadelphia Wings.
Deflected away from Williams. Casey Powell up with it for the West. And Powell with a neat long pass ahead that's bagged and could not be scored by Caleb Toth.
Oh, and the fans would have loved it if Caleb Toth scored. The only Calgary native in this lineup. They love all their Calgary players, but Caleb Toth is probably the favorite.
Great stop by Dallas Elliott. No sale there from the Price of Right guy.
Over and back call.
All right, Moss back out there again, giving it across for Ratcliffe. Ratcliffe fighting his way in front and shot it wide. Moss able to hang on to it there.
Ball now.
Shot lock, clock is down to 18, so still lots of time.
Watch the hands.
May be able to hear the referee yelling, watch the hands. Meaning the slashes on the hands.
Right? I think they need the hold.
Oh, the holding. Okay. Kluski with a shot that's off the cage of Elliott. Back ahead. A shot by Dan Teed is blocked aside as G. Nash came up strong. Nearing the halfway point of the third quarter. It is the West 7, the East 6. Long toss ahead is brought back in now by Jalbert. Across for shot. Getting the goal, his second of the game, Dan Dawson.
Dan Dawson becomes the first multiple goal scorer in this game. He opened the scoring early in the first half. And this is a nice passing play. Jalbert is in on a few goals. Two on one, and Dawson finishes it off. Dan Dawson has really turned his game around the last 2 years. He's hired a personal trainer, and he says he's just worked on his strength and it's just made a big difference.
Oh, a great shot by Mark Stainhouse. Stainhouse, who had six in last year's All-Star game, comes up with his first in this one, and the lead is trimmed to one.
Oh, and Stainhouse, a colorful player, as you can tell from his gloves and the orange shoes. And the hair, is that him sitting in the crowd? As you said, he was the MVP in the All-Star game last year, led the league with shorthanded goals, is tied for the lead in shorthanded goals this year. He's a great player and a fan favorite. Plays for Buffalo Bandits.
So this is Jesse Phillips from Calgary. Going back now to Gary Roziski. To Phillips again. Roziski able to move around in front. Little shovel across. Went right past the eyes of Dallas Elliott, the goalkeeper from Philadelphia,
okay,
and the East.
Go West, go!
In the midst of a line change now, the West All-Stars. Dawson gave it across. Gary Gate with it there. Nudged on. And a shot in front by Roziski was stopped by Elliott, who's been strong. In the most recent game played by his team, Philadelphia at Buffalo, he only gave up one goal in the entire second half of the contest. It has been rough and tumble here, but the West has the lead over the East. Middle stages, third quarter, 8-7.
Lacrosse is one of the most physically demanding sports, and the players need fast rehydration. Aquas Rapid Response Rehydration is one of the most effective rehydration products in the world. Designed for the U.S. military and validated by some of the world's leading rehydration scientists, Aquas provides superior rehydration through advanced technology for direct absorption into the bloodstream. When you need rehydration fast, drink Aquas, the official energy drink of the National Lacrosse League. Available at madlax.com.
To be the best, you have to learn from the best. How would you like to learn to shoot like Gary Gate and see the field like Ryan Boyle? Now you can. Through University Lacrosse, where hundreds of today's best players, coaches, and instructors are teaching high school players to be tomorrow's stars. Go to universitylacrosse.com and unleash the game.
Lead slinger Tony Graziani. His laser left arm and poise under pressure has Philly in a frenzy. Next up, a QB shootout fit for the Wild West as they host Cowboy Kid Clint Sterner and Dallas. Or Damian Hands Harrell in Colorado host Greg Hopkins and L.A. The AFL on NBC, Sunday, 3 Eastern.
Welcome back to Calgary and the All-Star Game. I'm Mark Morgan. Moments ago, Mark Stainhouse of the Buffalo Bandits with a nice goal for the East. Kind of a quirky guy, as Mike and Brian mentioned. Takes his lacrosse stick everywhere he goes, to the movie theater. When he and his girlfriend Vanessa go out, the stick rides between them in the front seat. In fact, the best story perhaps last year, right before the Championship Cup game here in Calgary, he was seen here in downtown Calgary with his lacrosse stick and the ball, bouncing the ball off of buildings. He says repetition was the key to him learning this sport. Again, this is a guy who didn't start playing lacrosse until he was 18 years old. Mike?
My goodness, what a tolerant lady.
To vote for the 2005 NLL All-Star MVP, text message star 47467. Stainhouse was the MVP last year and probably took the stick home and slept with it. Puck deflected away as this tight game at 8-7 inside the last 5 minutes of the third quarter. And here's Stainhouse taking some punishment, but holding.
I'll tell you, at this point, it'd be tough to pick an MVP. No one has dominated scoring from everybody.
Has a goalie ever won the MVP in an All-Star game? I doubt.
Yes, and don't forget the goaltenders. Don't forget the goaltenders. These guys have all played well.
Boy, O'Toole was very strong early, so was Cosmo. Eliuk has been as well. Oh, and Eliuk comes up big there. Another strong play by Dallas Eliuk. So now back on the attack, the East All-Stars. Fed across by Dan Teeth. The return pass fails. He's continuing on the attack. Blaine Manning took a little rush from Coyle. Manning feeds one in front. Just enough of a tip by Peter Luck of Arizona to cause that one to go away. Very deliberate. Sean Williams, a pass in front. Unable to connect and get a shot away was Glenn Clark.
All right, here comes.
Now brought back on the attack. With it is Powell. Circling the wagons, but his pass misfires for the rookie, Ryan Boyle, and careens all the way back.
And Casey Powell, another University of Syracuse graduate, a few of these guys out here. Of course, Gary Gate played at University of Syracuse and just turned the lacrosse world on its ear. The last three seasons there, his team only lost one game.
Marichek, boy, a number of fakes there, and then it went off the shoulder of Gene Ash.
Tom Marichek, another Syracuse grad. Played with Gary Gate there.
And a collection of the East players are either teachers full-time or are studying to be. There's one in front that's deflected away. Could not connect with Craig Kahn. Still to the outside in this tight game, 8-7. Little feed over to Blaine Manning. Another one in front that is grabbed off and sent ahead now by Gene Ash. Moving on in with it is Moss. And he went high with the shot. Follow-up shot. And that one went off of Colin Doyle. Oh, you'd have to be shaken up by that.
I said you rarely get hit with the ball. Once in a while, you take one on the legs. It's like a very hard punch.
Doyle has not left. The West continues to make a full-scale change. Fighting free is Ratcliffe. Shoots one, and getting a piece of that was Eliuk. Now moving in front, Toth, and Eliuk got that one. Fed in front and deflected away as they wanted to get it to Toth, either him or Kolesky. Kolesky emerges to the front. Oh, and it did couldn't go home. It was blocked aside by Eliak. Shot clock reset. In front, Kolarowski.
Oh,
getting a piece of it was Eliak. Out in front again. Another shot. They score! Lewis Radcliffe. Oh, my.
Well, that's a great goaltending by Dallas Eliak, but you had the Calgary contingent was on the floor there. Tracy Kolarowski, Lewis Radcliffe, tail up toe. I thought they were never going to score. Some great saves by Eliak before Lewis Radcliffe eventually puts this one in for his first of the game.
9-7, the West in the lead. A little over 2.25 minutes to go in the third quarter from Calgary.
Hello, I'm Lindsay Wagner. You know, if you're frustrated by the quality of your sleep or because you have morning back pain, please give us a call right now. It won't cost you a thing except a minute of your time. We'll immediately send you this free video and brochure with all the details about this amazing bed, including complete descriptions of all our bed models, prices, and options. You'll have all the information you need to make a decision that can truly make a difference in your sleep.
It's been amazing the difference that the Sleep Number bed has made with my sleep personally. I have not woken up with back pain at all, not once since we've gotten it.
I switched from an innerspring mattress to a Sleep Number bed, and now I sleep better than ever.
It's the only bed I know of that's clinically proven to improve your sleep quality and relieve back pain. And it also costs about the same as a traditional innerspring mattress, yet it lasts twice as long. Now, like most of us, before I got my Sleep Number bed, I used to toss and turn during the night. I'd wake up, roll over, find a comfortable position, and then go back to sleep. But on a Sleep Number bed, I actually sleep all the way through the night. And I didn't realize I wasn't getting a good night's sleep until I experienced one on a Sleep Number bed. I also noticed that I have more stamina during the day, and I know it's because I'm getting a more recuperative sleep. So why don't you call us right now and see if it isn't true for you as well.
Call for your free information kit. Sleep Number beds are easy to own, coming in all standard sizes with queen-size mattresses starting as low as $20 a month. Learn about our 20-year limited warranty and risk-free 30-night in-home trial. Call 1-800-609-7500. On a Sleep Number bed by Select Comfort, you can fall asleep faster, sleep more soundly, and wake up more refreshed. Call 1-800-609-7500. We'll rush you this free video, brochure, and price list. That's 1-800-609-7500. The Sleep Number bed is the key to a perfect night's sleep. Call now.
We await the announcement of another name, Rich.
All right, Bob, I've got it for you. Looking for Dallas Eliak. Come on down. You're the next contestant on The Price is Right.
I believe this young man is a professional lacrosse player. Dallas, aren't you one of the three professional lacrosse players?
Yes, I am, Bob.
Yeah, it's a pleasure to have you here.
You're the man. You're the man.
Thank you.
He actually got on the stage and won over $3,000 worth of merchandise. The only thing they got wrong is calling him a young man. Dallas Eliak, the veteran, is 40 years old now. Still plays like a young man.
Boy, he sure has in this quarter, hasn't he? 15 years as a goaltender in Philadelphia.
Over 5,000 saves, and that's number one in the league.
West in the dark, east in the silver here. Another attempt for the front fails. Oh, a little backhand attempt, too. It came from Ryan Cousins of Minnesota, and that was blocked off by Gene Ash.
The Philadelphia Wings, that Dallas Eliak has played, has won more championships than any team. Six championships in the NLL.
Go, 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 go!
I should state that John Grant's father was a star for the Philadelphia Wings in the 70s. John Grant Sr. That's why a lot of people call Grant John Grant Jr. to distinguish between the two superstars.
Boy, a great shift by Ryan Boyle we've been watching here. A steal and two shots. And now very deliberately they set up again with a two-goal lead. Under a minute and a half to go, and a shot rang off the pipe, and it was loose in front. Whoa. Going to be covered. Yeah, it is. Does not count as a goal. A loud clank off the pipe behind Eliak.
Wise play by Tavares to cover that up with his stick because that ball was loose. The West players were ready to dive and knock it in, and that would be a legal goal.
Ajax pass is flagged down and might be a breakaway, although there's a defensive change for the East. And just shoving his man off at the last moment, Casey Powell that time was the man who got back so quickly for the East, and that was Colin Doyle.
Yes, yes!
Now back they come again. A behind-the-back pass by Grant is flagged down by Dan Teat. Emerges to the front. Teat got it across. Shot was shanked away as Tavares let it go. Whip back in by Jim Veltman. Bounces to Tavares again.
The All-Star Skills Conference will give you the
second all-time leading score. 11 and silver, John Tavares with a pass that floated away from John Grant.
And you mentioned Jim Veltman. Jim, there's a stat in lacrosse called loose balls, and that's every time there's a ball that nobody has possession of, you win the battle, pick up that ball, you're awarded a loose ball. And Jim Veltman has led the league in loose balls every year he played. He took 1 year off in 94 to actually do missionary work with his wife in Africa, but he's the loose ball king, also third all-time in assist. He's been in the championship 10 times in his 12 years, has won the championship 7 times, and both, all these things are records. Jim Veltman, the captain of the Toronto Rock.
What a guy. Despite the pulling of the goaltender late, neither team could score nor get much of a shot. 3 quarters have been played. It is a 2-goal difference. National Lacrosse League's All-Star Game on NBC continues after these messages from your local NBC station.
Prepare for a new Law & Order series.
What's the spin?
For the first time.
I strangled her, threw the body down the well.
You'll go behind the scenes of the trial from every point of view.
I'm not interested in proving you innocent, just not guilty.
The building of the prosecution and the strategies of the defense.
I'd open with, ladies and gentlemen.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Where's the body?
Where's the body?
Bebe Neuwirth and Jerry Orbach in his final performances. The new Law & Order series, Trial by Jury, premieres Thursday after The Apprentice on NBC.
Remember the soothing feeling of mentholated vapors when you were a kid? Well, now you can take them with you all day long with new Vapor Shot, the personal vaporizer from Breathe Right.
Wow.
And for nighttime congestion,
mentholated.
Try Breathe Right Vapor Strips. Breathe better, feel better with Breathe Right.
At Direct, we're committed to increasing our customers by 25% over the next few months. We've opened neighborhood offices with new products, new payment plans, and the absolute best service ever. All this because we want your business. So before you spend another dollar on car insurance, call one of our local offices or our toll-free number at 1-800-444-4211.
Save a lot of money when you buy Direct.
Have you looked at your car's finish lately? Maybe it's time to get it painted. And now's the best time because Maaco is having a sale. At Maaco, you'll get a quality paint finish and a great deal. Best of all, Maaco will get the job done fast. Hurry and call today for a limited time only. Get half off our popular presidential paint package. If it's time to paint your car, visit your local Maaco Cosmovision specialist today.
Remember the soothing feeling of mentholated vapors when you were a kid? Well, now you can take them with you all day long with new Vapor Shot, the personal vaporizer from Breathe Right.
Wow.
And for nighttime congestion,
mentholated.
Try Breathe Right Vapor Strips. Breathe better, feel better with Breathe Right.
This is your NBC Action News Station, the home of Jeopardy.
Seven West, fourth quarter about to start, but downstairs we have Gary Gate, not only mic'd, but he can also hear us. Gary, your thoughts on the first three quarters so far?
Oh, thanks. It's been a lot of fun out here today.
Do you get a lot of young guys coming up to you during these games and talking about how you're the legend and how they grew up idolizing you?
No, it's just time to play. We realize we're here to put on a show and play, and I think all the guys are focused and on playing well and putting on a great show.
Gary, you played 14 seasons in this league, 14 times first team All-Pro. You've set every record, most goals, assists. How do you feel about the state of the game now that you're leaving it, I guess, passing the torch over to some of the younger guys? How do you feel what kind of shape this game is in now that you're leaving it?
I think this is in great shape. These young guys, I know I'm playing on this Western team, the All-Star age here is the youngest I've ever played on, and that just shows that there's a lot of young, great players coming up that are going to carry the game into the future.
Thanks very much for joining us. Good luck in the fourth quarter and the rest of the year.
Thank you.
Gary Gate, our guest here. His first game was played in Baltimore. He was a member of the Detroit team, the Turbos. There was snow. He had to land in Washington, get a cab to Baltimore. Only 11 of his teammates made it to the game, and none of them were goalies. That's so the equipment man played goal for about the first half, and then finally, Ted Sawicki, the goalkeeper for Detroit, arrived. They were down by 8, and they came back and won the game 20-16. I guess you don't forget your first game when it's like that.
First year in the league, he won the championship, scoring title, MVP. He hopes to end his career the same way, and Colorado's got a great team to do it.
Oh, a ripping, wheeling backhand shot from Tom Marichek, and it clanked off the glass. At that time, he said, I was making $80 a game and a senior at Syracuse. But much of that 80 would have been taken for that cab from Washington to Baltimore.
That 80 was gone shortly after the game.
Back on the attack now, the East down by 2. John Grant with it. Had it knocked away by Craig Gelsvik. That one off the glass and able to reach, but then losing it just that quickly was G. Nash. And so the East again can set up an attack. Ryan Cousins fed it back out. John Grant Jr. trying to shake free, put that one off Cousins, and then it was shot just wide. And it is lost ahead. Loose ball once more, and again it's grabbed off by the East. And it's Sean Williams, fed one in front. Backhander off the pipe from Colin Doyle. Just that close to being a one-goal game, and a two-on-one developing now for the West. Marching on in is Seller, and couldn't connect. Back they come again. It's the East on the attack this time. They've got a man ahead, and they give it to him. Fed across for a shot that went high and wide from Tavares, the guy they'd love to have in that position.
Oh, I think they just got a stick. Casey Powell just got his stick on Tavares as he shot that to deflect it.
Now they settle it down. Clock winks down to the last 10 minutes of the game. A hard, wheeling shot that came from Kolesky was blocked aside by Dallas Elliott. So the East with the ball, but trailing by 2. Errant pass, but they're able to recover now. Tavares, a shot, he scores! Blew it right through G. Nash, and it's 9-8.
And this one of John Tavares' coaches told me that people don't realize what a great outside shot he has, and in fact, they think it's developed more over recent years, and all that's done is open up his game even more. John Tavares, playing in his 14th season, is actually seems to improve with age. He's scoring over 7 points a game this year, a higher rate than his career.
Now here's Kahn moving in, gave it to Steinhaus, and a shot was blocked. Shot clock reset, ball turned back over to the West after 2 strong plays at the front by G. Nash. A shot went sailing wide from Gary Gate and ricochets all the way out over the line.
10 seconds for the East, Tavares.
So it is a one-goal game with 9.5 to go.
Well, we're going to be in for some good action here.
It could be a bumpy ride to the finish. When we get a moment, we want to just get in one more thing in case we forget or get tied up in the action later about the not only the quality of these guys, but the fact that they're so busy much of the year, not just playing lacrosse, but also earning another living. Meanwhile, it's Gavin Prout with his shot that was blocked aside, and Prout to the corner to battle there along with Hyatt. And what do we have here?
No penalties called. A minor interference. Often you'll think there's going to be a penalty call in this game. The referees just call a turnover for a minor interference.
Only one power play in the game. That to the West, and the East scored on a ripping shot by Craig Kahn in the second quarter. Ziski to the outside. To the front, he was shoved into the crease, got a shot away that was blocked off by Eliak. And play halted with 8:52 to go in the fourth and final quarter. It is the West having a narrow lead over the East to have gotten a pair of goals from John Tavares, 9-8.
Go!
You've got
broadband, you're ready to go. Visit Vonage.com or call 1-800-972-4VON. Now available at Best Buy, CompUSA, and Office Depot.
Take the dollar.
What's going on, man?
It won't take my dollar. Wow, that looks good.
Oh, yeah, it's new from KFC. Real chicken breast. Only a dollar.
You got that for a dollar?
Yeah. Took your dollar.
Oh.
Ready for a tasty bargain? Try the brand new 99-cent snacker from KFC. 100% hand-flowered chicken breast, pepper mayo, and crisp lettuce freshly prepared on a sesame seed bun. Now your dollar goes further at KFC.
It's an unfortunate fact of life that, according to the CDC, more than 33% of people aged 65 and older are involved in accidents and falls at home each year. Fortunately, help in regaining an active and independent lifestyle is just the push of a button away. A 24/7 monitored medical alarm system from Connect America provides peace of mind for only $29.95 per month. For more information, go to medicalalarm.com or call 1-800-906-0872.
The 2005 National Lacrosse League All-Star Game is brought to you by Vonage, the broadband phone company. By University Lacrosse. Go to universitylacrosse.com and unleash the game. By Aquas, rapid response rehydration, the official energy drink of the NLL. And by KFC's new 99-cent snacker. Now your dollar goes further at KFC, and we go further downstairs to Mark Morgan.
John Tavares' second goal pulls the East within one. What can we expect the rest of this game?
Well, hopefully we can get some more shots. Right now we're trying to finesse everything in and make the perfect pass. And, you know, we're not taking enough shots right now. And being down by one goal, you got to start shooting the ball.
Our announcer spoke to Gary Gate moments ago. His name and your name are always mentioned by all the young players prior to this game about how much they admire you. What does that mean to you?
Well, I mean, it makes a lot when you can make an impact in any sport. You know, Gary and I have been around for a long time, so it's nice to know we made a mark in the game.
Enjoy the rest of the game.
Thank you.
All right, Mike.
Thank you. He'll be going back to his job teaching on Monday.
Yeah, a lot of these players, most of these players have full-time jobs in other professions. We have firefighters, police officers. In fact, there are 8 teachers on the East team, 1 on the West, including John Tavares on the East. 5 of these guys all went to the same college, Duville College in Buffalo, and they're great ambassadors to the school. They're very proud of them. There's another teacher, I think, just scored there.
You're right.
Jim Veltman.
Jim Veltman just wheeled one, and this game is tied up at 9 apiece with 8:35 to go.
I mean, this is exactly what you want in an All-Star game. Tied up with 8 minutes to go. Jim Veltman is actually known more of a passer than a shooter, but he's got a deceiving shot. Not the hardest shot, but he takes something off. Seems to put a little bit of English on it, a bit of spin. Goalies hate when he shoots.
Here is Jalbert. Hey, Jalbert, looking around through traffic. Another line change this time for the East. Moving ahead with this is Jim Moss, who's already scored one. Moss doing that move behind the net, which worked before. The outside, it goes to Gate. Gate a shot and a strong save again by Eliak. Many of you are voting for the MVP of the game. You'll get a flat screen TV. Goaltenders have been very strong in this. The score is 9-9. A little pass in front. Oh, and a shot by Tavares trying for the hat trick. And it is grabbed off by G. Nash.
Great save by G. Nash. John Tavares doesn't miss too often when he gets a scoring opportunity.
Away from cooling, it's Powell. Powell trying to finesse one in front. Oh, the shot ricocheted off the crossbar. Oh, from Koloski. And another try in front. Oh, the net dislodged. And it's back the other way. Helter skelter.
Oh, boy. That's a tough one for the referee, because if it crosses the plane, it's supposed to count whether the net's there or not.
Oh, and Eliak reacts after he put the net back himself. Oh. Now Koloski tries the steal. Dan Teed able to knock it away. Koloski diving too. Touched it back ahead. And it's Teed up with it, but denied by Koloski. And then sent flying on the play was Lewis Ratcliffe.
Oh, that's good old-time lacrosse. That's great.
A hard drive by Toth. A rebound that went wide by Koloski. And another shot that is too high. Now it's Toth working to the outside. And it's Gate a shot. And it bounces back. It's no goal. No goal.
I am sure referee Chet Couture originally signaled that as a goal. And I think it probably was. It's a tough call. Because when the net is knocked off, all that really counts, you have to visualize where the net would be. And Gate just shot in that direction. Let's see if we think this would be a goal. It's hard to tell because you can't tell what height it is from that angle, but I think that's a legitimate goal, but I wouldn't want to be the referee.
The voice wearing the stripes up here, Brian Shanahan, along with Mark Morgan downstairs. Yours truly, Mike Emmerich, enjoying this All-Star game. We hope you are. Good underhand shot that time that came from John Grant, but was locked away by G. Nash, and the West back on the attack in this tie game. 6 1/4 minutes to go in it. Settle it down a little bit now. Kate is out there, the captain of this team. Ryan Boyle, the rookie, shovels it back over. Gavin Prout fighting free. Prout in front. Kick back out by Elliott. Turned back all the way out to the neutral area. Rod back ahead, charging on with it as Thomas Hayek of Philadelphia feeds it back for a ripping shot that bounced off one of the defenders. Ryan Cousins let it go, and we get a whistle and halt to play with 5:44 to go. Fourth quarter, 18 goals have been scored, equally divided, the East 9 and the West 9.
Lacrosse is one of the most physically demanding sports, and the players need fast rehydration. Aquas Rapid Response Rehydration is one of the most effective rehydration products in the world. Designed for the U.S. military and validated by some of the world's leading rehydration scientists, Aquas provides superior rehydration through advanced technology for direct absorption into the bloodstream. When you need rehydration fast, drink Aquas, the official energy drink of the National Lacrosse League. Available at madlax.com. It's an unfortunate fact of life that, according to the CDC, more than 33% of people aged 65 and older are involved in accidents and falls at home each year. Fortunately, help in regaining an active and independent lifestyle is just the push of a button away. A 24/7 monitored medical alarm system from Connect America provides peace of mind for only $29.95 per month. For more information, go to medicalalarm.com or call 1-800-906-0872.
Hi, I'm Gary Gaty, the Colorado Mammoth. Do you want to separate yourself from the pack? If you're a high school lacrosse player, the National Developmental Program is a series of high school lacrosse tournaments for boys and girls that will showcase your talents to college coaches. These tournaments are designed to provide you with an extensive learning opportunity to sharpen your skills and help you show college coaches what you can do. Parents and coaches, NDP is the best, most cost-effective way to manage your kids' college search. NDP, building your college lacrosse future today. Separate yourself from the pack at ndplacrosse.com.
Tiger Woods, after an un-Tiger-like 04, his roar is back and the tour better look out. Phil Mickelson, sizzling hot with 2 wins this year. Vijay Singh, coming off last year's 9-win explosion. It's a lineup loaded with 9 of the top 10 stars, all looking to tame the Blue Monster. The Ford Championship at Doral. Coverage begins next Saturday, 3 Eastern, NBC.
Since its inception, the National Lacrosse League has seen several so-called dynasties. The Philadelphia Wings were the first, winning 6 titles. The Buffalo Bandits stormed onto the scene in the early 90s, winning 3 titles, including a record 21-game winning streak. The Toronto Rock were up next, and they went on to win 4 titles, and perhaps the next dominant team will be the Calgary Roughnecks, who defeated Buffalo last season to win the 2004 championship.
We talked about the Toronto Rock there in first place right now in the Eastern Division. Buffalo and Rochester behind. Only 3 teams from each division make the playoffs. That's why every game is like a playoff game, and the West is pretty tight as well. Colorado tied with Calgary for first. Arizona and San Jose battling, but things can change. That is why it is so exciting. There's going to be some good teams not make the playoffs, so every game has got a lot of intensity.
Moving in. Taken by Elliott was Dan Dawson, looking for the third goal.
That was Dan Dawson's famous swim move. 6'5", he's great at it.
See what he does here. Dawson from the Arizona Sting. Wrapped up, and thanks to that reach in that came from Glenn Clark, the East is able to escape. Bringing this ahead, it's fed back over to Clark, and his shot is shrugged away by G. Nash after he'd gotten the pass from Stainhouse. 5 minutes to go, fourth quarter in the game tie.
Well, I don't know who's going to win the MVP, but these goaltenders will get some votes. All 4 of them, including Dallas Elick and G. Nash, have played fantastic, showing why they should be here.
Beg your pardon, Sean Williams holding on to this.
Loose. 10
Voters
seconds.
Tend to favor offensive players, don't they? Boy, the goalkeeping has been sparkling. You're right. Elliott, despite having the goal knocked down a couple of times, still making saves. All right, this is the East again. Long pass ahead to Tavares. Leads it on a cross. Then Tavares, very deep in the hole, and a shot is blocked aside. Getting a piece of it was Nash, and back comes the West with 4:20 to go. Tie game. They move it right in. Powell, a shot that went wide. Bounces all the way back. Head manned on by Tavares, but it ricocheted off Hayek and it started back for the West. It is Powell again looking over the traffic as there's another change in lines from his coach Chris Hall.
Powell has to be a little winded after that last run. He needs to settle down for a few seconds.
Jalbert to the outside. Jay Jalbert putting on some moves. Fires one that's spiked away by Eliak. And able to take it in stride is John Tavares moving on back. Tavares fed it across to Cousins. He scores! Ryan Cousins, and it's 10-9 the East.
Well, the captain of the expansion Minnesota Swarm will make his fans proud. Another defender who rarely runs up over center joins John Tavares on that rush. Jalbert widely forced Tavares to make the pass. Who do you want to shoot, Tavares or defender? But the defender, Cousins, put it in from Toronto, Ontario. Great goal. Big lead late in the game. Need to get big lead. Momentary lead late in the game.
Winning team personnel get portable DVD players to take back with them if you're on the winning side. Not to mention the flat-screen TV for the MVP of the game, but it is 10-9 the East with 3.25 minutes to go. A lot of jostling for position. And a shot ricocheted off the pipe from Tom Marichek of the Philadelphia Wings. West back to the offense again. Moving it ahead is Craig Gelsvik from the Calgary Roughnecks, trying to escape cooling. Then it's turned back over to the East. Laid back ahead once more for Andrew Turner of Minnesota, who moves in. Drops the pass on back. It's fed across for a shot that's turned aside by G. Nash. 2:45 to go as of right now, and the West moving it back. Nice shake move as Jim Moss is able to escape. Gets the pass on across. Got it to Rosicki. On back for shot.
What a great play by Dawson and a nice pass from Rosicki. Dawson just held his stick up there for the big target. And once he got that pass, he wasn't going to be stopped by Elliott. Third goal of the game. Great effort.
Play is stopped with 2:38 to go in the tilt. And it is the West 10 and the East 10.
Start the day with a splash. Bring on the blue.
Moving to the horizon.
Splash. Bring on the blue.
Now you're flying again.
That aqua velvet face, so firm, so fit.
First tone skin.
That manly scent.
Jump right in.
Bring on the blue. Comes that cool blast you're feeling.
Splash.
Bring on the blue. As she touches your skin.
It just feels better with an aqua velvet man.
You have to learn from the best. How would you like to learn to shoot like Gary Gate and see the field like Ryan Boyle? Now you can. Through University La Crosse, where hundreds of today's best players, coaches, and instructors are teaching high school players to be tomorrow's stars. Go to universitylacrosse.com and unleash the game.
World champion Chelsea Memel. This rising American star headlines the next crop of Olympic hopefuls at the American Cup, presented by TJ Maxx, live next on NBC.
NBC Monday, it's Fear Factor Reality All-Stars, but don't think we're going to be going easy on them. Fear Factor Reality All-Stars, NBC Monday at 8, 7 Central.
Dan Dawson, the Arizona Sting, has tied this game with a hat trick. His hat trick goal made this 10-10, 2:38 to go in the fourth quarter. If they're tied at the end of regulation, there will be a sudden death overtime period. First goal wins.
And that is the way you play a regular season game as well. Every tie game goes into overtime until a winner.
Boy, what a whipping shot by Tavares just now that was answered by G. Nash. That will be a 5-minute sudden death overtime period. Great, these goalies are going. Five might not be enough. Hard shot by Tavares went wide. And it's Tavares. Oh, the pass for him went wide. Colin Doyle to play it there. Young man from the Toronto Roxies. Tavares at the front, but there's not a clear opening to pass, so he moves out himself. Fed it across. Oh, save made by G. Nash. Tavares was at the side of the net.
Doc, that was a phenomenal save by Nash on Tavares there. You won't see a better save than that.
Back they come now. John Grant with it for the East. Down he goes. Jim Moss provides the impetus there, and back now rushes the West with 90 seconds to go. Powell with a pass, and it is held by Prout around behind. Gavin Prout, very deliberate now. He's got Toth, the local man for the Roughnecks, and gives it to him. Laid back across in the final minute, 15, tie game. The feed to Gate in front, kicked out by Elliott, and the net dislodged. Oh, Gate with the game on his stick, perhaps.
Oh, pretty good defense by Ryan Cousin. Just pushed Gate into the crease. And if you step into that crease, whether you were pushed or not, you can't score. Good defense.
Mike Hazen gave it over to Tavares. 1 minute to go. Shot clock with 17 in front. Tavares in, answering him again is G. Nash. And Nash up with the ball. Long pass ahead to Jim Moss. Moving ahead. The East rushing to get men out. Moss' shot save. Elliott. Rebound. Oh, and he got that one too. Off the shot by Jesse Phillips. Down to the last 38 in a 10-10 tie. My, oh, my. Holding on to it now is Mark Stainhouse. The East completes a change in lines. They work it to the outside, 25 to go. It's given on a cross for a little lob in front that missed for John Grant. Dug out by Dan Teat. Shot clock at 7. Backhand shot went wide from Tavares. And 2 seconds and 1. And the shot clock has expired, so 12.3 to go.
Watch the West to pull their goaltender here with just 12 seconds to go.
All the Gunners are out for the All-Stars on the West. It's Prout handing it across. Shot skips wide and bounce all the way back past Dawson, and we will need sudden death. We see 0.2 seconds up on the board, and it could very well be that the quarter is over and that we will have this 5-minute sudden death overtime period. But there's only a fraction.
Yeah, he was not even going to take it. Yes, okay. Overtime, and that's fitting because this has been a great game. Some great saves, and I don't know who's going to win the MVP, but G. Nash just made some incredible saves of John Tavares in the last few minutes.
Well, let's watch some of this goaltending artistry that has occurred in this game that in the past has always been thought of a goalie's nightmare, but they have played it with such intensity and the goaltenders have responded too.
Yeah, not to give all the credit to Nash, Dallas Elliott has played great as well. But you are getting the best shooters coming down. That stick save by Nash was amazing on John Tavares. Looked like he was shooting for the empty net. That stick came out of nowhere.
Elioc, Rob, Gary Gate. A lot of poetry would have been written about that had he been able to score. But Elioc robbed him, and we are in a sudden
and
death period.
Get ready. This could end quick. Most overtimes in this league end within the first minute.
And we get the ball signaled to the West. So the West will have the first clear possession, 9 seconds into the sudden death period. They have Gate out there at 22, Prout 69, 42 is Lewis Ratcliffe. Also out there is the big goal scorer today, Dan Dawson, among others. So it's Gate, holding, shooting, save Elioc, and he dives out and traps it. Ball will go back over to the East.
No holding back. The best offensive players from the best in the league will be on the floor, and the best defensive players will be out against them.
Stainhouse holding. G. Nash, superb in the nets. To the outside, Colin Doyle. Fed one in front, and the bouncer was well wide. Stainhouse again, 10 left on the shot clock. On back to Tavares, a couple of moves. Can't shake free, then she goes!
What a great game and what a great goal. Jimmy Moss, one of the best defenders, didn't give Tavares much, but he reaches over. What a fantastic effort. If I had wanted anyone to check Tavares, I would want Moss checking him. Tavares, as he's done so many times in his career, scores that beautiful goal when he looks like he's got nothing to go for. Look at that. Look at the bad angle on this play. He's pushed off balance. Excellent goal, but excellent game from everyone out here.
Well, you talk about 36 of the best, including four goalkeepers. And did they ever give their very best in this contest today?
And Moss argued with the ref for a second about the crease, but when you see that replay, that's a legitimate goal. He dove through the crease, and that ball was in the net before Tavares touched the ground. Great goal, great game.
The most impressive thing to me during the course of this past week is meeting some of these players, and not only what gentlemen they are, but how they spend so much of their spare time either coaching or being ambassadors for the sport, not only in the National Lacrosse League, but also in their local communities.
Yeah, you said it, and we talked to Tracy Kolesky and how humble he was, and we just heard he was named by the fans as the MVP, and that's a great choice. Kolesky at 4 points, a goal and three assists. And as we spoke to him yesterday, and we were asking him about his career at University of Hartford, how he played there, and he said, all right. And he very humbly said he led the nation in points, but no big deal. And these guys are all like that. Gary Gay, John Tavares, very humble about their achievements. They just love this game, and they want to see it do well.
John Tavares, the winning goal scorer, is downstairs with Mark.
Mike, thanks very much. John, I know the result was what you wanted. How did you get there to score the game-winning goal?